Have you ever seen these kind of ferns?
Hey everybody, and welcome back to the garden. Today I want to show you something that I got living on one of my trees. It's a maple tree, but if you've ever been down to South Georgia and you see the huge live oaks and you see the frilly things on the trees, sometimes they're green, sometimes they're brown. This is probably what you're seeing. Look right here.
So this right here is a resurrection fern. And the botanical name is Pleopeltis polypodioides. It is a native fern to southeastern America. Now, a lot of times you can see this stuff living very, very happily with moss on the branches of trees.
Now, this fern is closely compared to Spanish moss, and it's not gonna hurt your tree. And look what I found. I found this cocoon in here, and the fern fronds are literally wrapped around it.
This plant can lose 75 to 97% of its moisture content, whereas most other plants can only lose about 10% before they die. This is an epiphyte with rhizomes, and you see the rhizomes here, but they don't steal nutrients from their host, and they can grow on other plants and structures. These ferns love oak trees, magnolias, and cypresses, but I've also seen them on a handful of other things, you know, like stumps and fallen logs and rocks and fence posts and buildings. And they grow from New York to West Texas and down to Florida because of its ability to handle extreme drought. Now, when this thing dries out, it makes the tree trunks look fuzzy as it turns an old brownish grayish similar to the host tree. But once it gets watered again, it comes back to life. It looks beautiful, green, and healthy. They found some before that were 100 years old, and they still resurrected. And that's why it's called a resurrection fern. These resurrection ferns are air plants, and their fronds can be 4 to 12 inches long. They reproduce by spores, not seeds. And you can see them right here in the sori on the underside of their fronds. And just a side note, true ferns typically have these structures called sori under their fronds. But when they dry out, the fronds curl over with their undersides turned up. That way they can better absorb any incoming moisture. They have sterile and fertile fronds. If it doesn't have these sores on it, then it is sterile. And if you look right here, wherever there's a sore, you look on the other side and you can see a little pock. The spores can spread on the breeze. This will happen around fall time or usually around October. Now, if you want one of these, go out and find a tree that has, you know, is covered with them. And if you can find a broken branch, you can take that home and transplant it by attaching that broken branch securely and firmly so that any new rhizome growth can attach to the new host tree right there.
This is how I attached it, but it's attached. I can actually take these things off the tree now.
And this is what it looks like in January. Just beautiful. And here's that cocoon that I showed you back in the summer. It looks like it's still intact. Oh, how cool.
This resurrection fern grows best in part shade, and it is an evergreen. You can grow it inside if you want to, but you gotta mist it and fertilize with a water-soluble fertilizer about once a month. It is pest and disease-free, and it's just a really great plant to have.
Now, in the Ozarks, there's a plant that looks very similar to this, except it has longer fronds, and they're over a foot long, and the patches grow on rocks and boulders. And one really cool thing before we go, this fern rode the space shuttle Discovery into space in 1997 because they wanted to watch its resurrection in zero gravity. Very cool fern.
You'll probably start noticing these things now that you know what they are. And I appreciate y'all watching, and we'll see you here next time back at the garden.